Welcome to The Keypoint, presented by Keypoint Intelligence. We help you cut through the noise of data, offering unbiased insights in printing technology and communications.
At Keypoint Intelligence, we transform data into analysis, testing into tools, and insights into strategy. We provide strategic planning resources, including market research, competitive intelligence, testing, sales training, go-to-market support, and customer engagement to supplier and service providers.
Hello, and welcome to another edition of the Keypoint Podcast. I'm your host, Eric Zimmerman. I am the principal analyst for wide format print services here at Keypoint Intelligence, and I am joined today by Canon's worldwide senior marketing director of wide format, Mathieu Peeters. Welcome to the Keypoint, Mathieu.
Thank you very much, Eric. Nice to be here.
Glad to have you. Mathieu, to get the ball rolling, I've been stating in this series of podcasts we've been doing for a bit that there's an overarching theme living in the time of now. And as consumers, what I mean by time of now is we expect it now. We can order just about anything online and within 24 hours, or, you know, often faster, we can have it delivered to our doorstep. So looking at this from a wide format perspective, it seems to be going even further, right? Not only do print buyers want it now, but they also want it customized. And in many cases, they just want a small quantity or maybe only one, you know, personalization, if you will. So we're fortunate to have Mathieu here with us today to provide us his industry insight and discuss what the future of wide format kind of mapping out to be. So Mathieu, let's jump right into it. There's so many ways to address the market needs, right? We got UV flatbed, UV gel, roll to roll, aqueous printing, et cetera. So as we move further into 2024, gosh, almost 2025, what are some of the print buying trends and application innovations that you see going on out there?
Yeah, exactly. I totally agree with what you're saying, Eric. And I see three major trends. First of all, print service providers, they want to do more with less. And automation is key. And with automation, I mean not only software automation, but also finishing automation, the total chain from job submission up to finished product ready. And that is the trend number one. And the second one is that you see that print service providers want to expand their business opportunities. So they want to enter into new vertical markets and new applications, like, for example, interior decor and packaging. And the third one, I would say print buyers, they are requiring that their suppliers, or let's say the print service providers, to be trusted advisors, extremely quick deliveries, as you just mentioned. So 60% of the jobs done within 24 hours. With also competitive pricing, and besides, the print buyers are requiring more and more sustainable end products. These are, to my opinion, the three major trends you see in the market.
All right. Well, that's pretty all-encompassing right there. We definitely touched on how the industry is changing. What type of technology and hardware and software, just from a Canon point of view, are you seeing being used to produce these types of products?
We just had the Drupa, where we met each other, Eric. I'm not allowed to tell you a number, but we are, as Canon, are investing a substantial percentage of our revenues in research and development. So innovation is the name of the game in production printing, and we want to be a number one player in this. Our main proposition is to offer state-of-the-art flatbed printers, and we do it with the well-known Arizona series, roll-to-roll printers, which are our Colorado series printers, including workflow automation. And we do it with the Prisma XL suite. And furthermore, I would like to emphasize that we can't do it all by our own. That's why we introduced the ambassador programs. And we have ambassador programs for software, media, and finishing. And we are working there closely together, provide those finishing software ambassadors, open interfaces, software development kits, so that we can create vertical solutions together. And with the media manufacturers, we are working closely together to get the best running applications and test it in-house in our test labs.
Okay. Wow.
Furthermore, if I may continue, as you saw on Drupa, we launched the UVGL packaging factory where we can enable a litho lamination application. So print from roll and from a jumbo roll, print on it with the UVGL technology, and then cut that into sheets, full bleed, so that they can be laminated on, let's say, a third-party finisher, such as Lamina, which can be then cut and creased to digital package. And what you already know from us, which we launched, I think, I'm not sure, it was 2020, 2021, the UVGL wallpaper factory for fully automated digital wallpaper printing, going from, let's say, jumbo roll to UVGL printing, XY cutting, and printing, let's say, the rolls ready to ship in 53 centimeters, 10 meters, and 20 centimeters high, so that it's completely ready to ship without any manual interaction. And on request of our customers who want to do offline finishing, Eric, we launched the UVGL Print Factory, enabling roll in and roll out. Yeah, we have a beautiful solution there for offline finishing generic applications. But, you know, this is, to my opinion, only 5 to 10% of the market is highly advanced, fully automated streets. We have lots of productivity features in our standard offering as well, which is interesting for 90% of our customers. And that is simply the fact is with the Colorado, we have an extremely productive technology where we typically replace 2 or 3 1 meter 60 or 64 inch roll-to-roll printers with one Colorado M series. Or with the Arizona, we launched at the ISA in America, the FlexFlow technology, where it's not needed anymore to tape or to mask because of our flow technology. And we also provide their reverse flow so that operators can easily position the substrate on the table without any hassle. And maybe you saw that already earlier, and we productized our robot automation interface for the Arizona flatbed printers so that our customers can integrate their partner of choice to do fully automated print, cut, or print and cut 24/7. We also have the Prisma suite I just mentioned in the beginning, Prisma XL suite, where we have launched our latest edition of Prisma Guide XL for job automation so that you can submit jobs which are processed according to a predefined recipe where you can change the file which are processed in exactly the same way, getting the knowledge out of the operators into the system, which will reduce waste and reduce also, of course, waste of time. And last but not least, I also think that's getting more and more important, Eric, is our services and warranty offering. So we offer an extended warranty and service program in order to maximize the uptime at the print service providers and print factories.
Well, I think that is about the most thought out answer I've heard to date. The information, it matches perfectly. I mean, we're looking at all the things that change in the industry, right? Only in more and more increasing demand for fast turnaround. Canon seems to have done a really good job from, you know, beginning to end workflows of with this automation, allowing and partnering, like you said, in your ambassador programs to really put all the pieces together. And the wallpaper factory years back was really impressive. And to see that that is moving into other things as well, it's a smart workflow. But to your point, what I think is even more impressive is you recognize that that's a small percentage of the market. So putting those other features in for, say, the rest of us, you know, the smaller shops or the mid-volume, just makes it that much easier to maybe grow into a production like that too. So then you mentioned expanding into markets and other things outside of just quote unquote wide format. That's something that we're seeing quite a lot of. So addressing that is fantastic. And spending that time in R&D, not only to help on the product side of things, but on that market research side of things is super important. So it seems like you're really covering what those print buyers want. You know, they want these things now. They want them right. They want them customized. You got solutions for it. And it sounds like the solutions are scalable.
Exactly.
Give me your final thoughts on it, you know, moving into the second half of the year and beyond from a Canon point of view. We say in America, we say, how do you put a bow on that?
Right. That's a good one. I would say the wide format market will continue to flourish. And we are using your beautiful market analysis reports as input.
Thank you.
Yeah, we see an interior decor, huge growth in canvas printing, wall covering. We see in retail banners, point of purchase, and posters who have very large volume. But window graphics is growing the fastest, even 10% continuous growth. And within the display and packaging, we see a growth of 18%, where we see that very interesting litho lamination market, representing 13% of the total digital packaging market, where we have all vertical solutions for. So looking at the second half, you can count on us, let's say, from a technology point of view, furthermore, increasing, improving, innovating our portfolio. But on the other hand, I think I didn't tell you yet, since December 1st last year, I'm not only doing the marketing part, so the global marketing part, but also the application support, the applications expert group.
And
we really want that we don't only do the why and the what from a marketing perspective, but also the how. So we want to help our print service providers how to do things in an easier way, how to do it in a better way. For example, elevation of print. There's a huge trend on a throughput, but some print service providers don't really know how to do it, how to get that grayscale, how to get the right production with the least amount of effort. So I also want to put effort in it to enable the market from that point of view. Yeah.
Excellent. Ties it all together where that I really like that adding in that how-to, right? And the technical side of things. Being the old sign geek that I am, I love seeing new applications and learning all more about these things. So it's exciting news. Matthew, can't thank you enough for taking the time out of your busy schedule to have a chat with me. It's always a great conversation. If people want more information on Canon products and services, where is the best place to start?
That's a very good question. Of course, they can go to the regional Canon authorized sales partner or Canon national sales organization online or in person. Furthermore, besides the trade shows like FASPA, we talked about the visual impact in Brisbane we just had. We have the Printing United coming up at Las Vegas, the 10th to the 12th September. Please join us there. And of course, yeah, I would say, feel free to connect with me via LinkedIn. More than happy to be your digital connection in order to show you the trends where we are going to. And furthermore, we have our Graphic Plaza, a large format graphics community, where you are free to subscribe to our graphic newsletter, which you get received then every 2 weeks, where we share best practices, new applications from a global point of view. Maybe that's also interesting for some of the listeners to your podcast, Eric.
Definitely. Well, again, thank you so much. And as always, we want to thank our listeners. We hope you enjoyed this episode of The Key Point, and we look forward to seeing you next time.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you for listening to another edition of The Key Point.
Listen to all of our episodes on your favorite podcast channel or on our website at keypointintelligence.com. Just click on the Resources tab to view podcasts in the drop-down menu.